Now get along with you. Get along with you.
Quick.
A spell in the new world will do you a power of good. You'll be far from the distractions and temptations of London's theatrical life. Your mother is very disappointed in you, Cyril. This last episode, in joining a company of acrobats, was really the last straw. Now, Cyril, take this letter to my nephew in New York. He will look out for your interests. And Bertie will help you to find a good, steady job. Dear Bertie, this is to introduce Cyril Bassington-Bassington. At all costs, ensure that he does not come into contact with theatrical circles.
Sorry. Sorry.
Well, you're allowed to blink, you know.
Yeah, really?
Oh, I wish you'd relax, Bertie.
What do you mean, relax?
Well, move your lips when you speak, that sort of thing.
Won't you come out blurred?
Well, that's enough for today, anyway.
I say, dashed exhausting this, you know.
Oh, that'll be Muriel.
I think I might give this to my Aunt Agatha. She thinks I do absolutely nothing in New York.
Are you ready to come to rehearsal yet?
Oh, Bertie, this is Miss Singer.
It would be wonderful if you could help us, Mr. Wooster.
Oh, how do you do? This is George Caffin. George writes plays and all that sort of thing.
Hello.
Muriel and I are engaged.
Engaged? What about your uncle?
My uncle will just have to lump it.
Oh, Corky's just being brave, Mr. Wooster.
I'm sure he'll see straight away that you're all the perfect wife for Corky.
No, he won't. All he'll consider is that I've gone and taken an important step without his advice. He'll cut my allowance.
Ooh.
And try to force me to go into the jute business again.
Jute, eh? Oh, yes, I see.
Bertie, are we going to rehearsal?
Yes, right. Well, look, I tell you what. I promise you I'll give this matter my best attention.
It would be wonderful if you could think of something, Mr. Wooster.
Right.
This is the part where the butler comes in and tells you the house is on fire. So, blah, 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 panic, off you all go. You want to take over, Herman? Thank you. Well, what do you think?
Terrific. I love the song.
Look, Bertie, we haven't cast our part of the butler yet. You wouldn't want to play it, would you?
No. I'm a complete fool at that sort of thing.
Oh, look, I know it's only a small part, but we're really looking for an Englishman to play it.
No, I played Brutus at school once, and I was the one everybody stabbed. Thank you, Jeeves. And now, Jeeves, I'm going to see Corky's uncle, who's in the jute business. To tell you the truth, I'm a bit foggy on what jute is. Apparently, it's something that the populace at large is pretty keen on, because Corky's uncle has made a hefty stack out of it. Have you come across it at all?
Jute is a fibre from the bark of the plant Corcoran capsularis. It is imported chiefly from Bengal and used in the making of canvas or gunny.
Canvas or gunny, right. Yes, well, that's made things pretty clear, Jeeves. Thank you.
Will that be all?
Yes, that'll be all. Thank you, Jeeves. Oh, Jeeves.
Sir?
This gunny stuff. I mean, I know about canvas, but gunny seems to have just slipped my mind.
Gunny is a coarse material chiefly used for sacking, sir.
Ah, right, of course. Sacking, gunny, sacking, yes. Thank you, Jeeves.
Wooster, sir.
Ah, Mr. Wooster. Welcome to our country.
Ah, right. Well, thanks awfully.
Please, sit down, Mr. Wooster. It's always a pleasure to meet another Jute man. I love Jute. You see this model of a yellow-bellied sapsucker? Made entirely from Jute.
Good Lord.
This entire edifice you see around you, built on Jute.
Really? Pretty useful stuff, then.
Frankly, Mr. Wooster, I'm surprised to see you here.
Oh? Well, yes, the thing
you
is...
You British usually import directly from India, don't you?
Yes, generally speaking, we do. We import...
Don't get me wrong. I can supply you with 1,000 bales a week at 360 a bale, FOB.
FOB? Well, no, I don't think we want any of that, no.
You're in the manufacturing line, aren't you? Animal feed bagging?
Yes, that's right. Yes, dog biscuits, cat... things. Sacking. All sorts of sacking. Sack races, of course.
Sack races?
Yes, that's our main line. And of course, we're right at the start of the sack race season now, so obviously we're snowed under with orders at the moment.
Mr. Wooster.
Mr. Warble, do you ever think about love?
Do I?
You know, raising a family.
Are we talking about Jute or...?
The patter of tiny feet, the, Right, well, thank you. We'll be letting you know.
Yes, well, of course, he's not the easiest of chaps to get along with, I imagine, but I'd go so far as to say he was impressed.
What did he say about us getting engaged, Mr. Wooster?
Yes, well, I think we actually sort of mentioned that.
What?
But for a very good reason. Because the whole thing suddenly became clear to me. All you have to do is to work it so that your uncle makes Miss Singer's acquaintance without his knowing that you know her. And all you do is come along and...
But how can we make it work that way?
Ah, yes, well, that's the catch. Well, there's only one thing to do.
What?
Leave it to Jeeves. Now, let's get a cab, shall we? Taxi! Now, Jeeves, we want your advice.
Very good, sir. Good morning, miss. Good morning, Mr. Corcoran.
This is Miss Singer, Jeeves. She is Mr. Corcoran's fiancée.
I hope you will be very happy, Miss Singer. Congratulations, Mr. Corcoran.
Yes, Jeeves. Now, the difficulty is that Mr. Corcoran's uncle, being accustomed to working with canvas or gunny, which doesn't answer back very much, doesn't like Mr. Corcoran doing anything without asking his permission first. He particularly won't like Corky getting engaged, which he has, to Miss Singer.
Quite so.
Right, so my thought was that if Mr. Warple made Miss Singer's acquaintance first, or what he thinks is first, and then along comes old Corky, apparently a newcomer...
I understand, sir. I do have an idea which I believe fits the bill.
Good Lord, Jeeves.
The scheme I have, sir, which, while certain of success, does require a certain financial outlay.
Oh, now, look here, dash it, Miss Singer, don't start crying, don't they? Look, Corky, you can count on me for all that sort of thing. You know, only too glad. Carry on, Jeeves.
Thank you, sir. What I would suggest is that Mr. Corcoran take advantage of Mr. Warple's attachment to ornithology.
How did you know my uncle was interested in birds?
No, oh, I've read with great pleasure Mr. Warple's two books, American Birds and More American Birds. What I was going to suggest is that Miss Singer write a small volume entitled, let us say, The Children's Book of American Birds, and that she dedicate it to Mr. Warple. It would be a limited edition at your expense, sir.
Well, let's see how that's going to help Jeeves.
A great deal of the book would be given over to eulogistic remarks concerning Mr. Warple's own treatise, sir. And I would further recommend the dispatching of a presentation copy to Mr. Warple immediately on publication.
But I can't write a book.
Oh, yes, you can.
I don't even write interesting letters.
I fancy it would be fairly simple to find some impecunious young writer, miss, who would be only too glad to do the actual composing of the volume for a small fee. It is only necessary that the young lady's name appear on the title page, sir.
Couldn't you do it, Mr. Jeeves? I'm sure you could. You seem to know so much, and you talk so nicely.
I hardly think...
Well, now you see you could, you know, Jeeves.
I can't wait to get there.
But I must have done it.
Don't believe in stoplights?
I say, look here.
Very good, sir. I'll do that, sir.
I shall inform Mr. Wooster, sir. Goodbye.
Well, Jeeves?
That was a Mr. Cyril Bassington-Bassington, sir.
Never heard of him. What did he want?
He was telephoning from a police station, sir. He was requesting for you to go round and bail him out.
Well, what a dashed nerve. Phyllis phoned you up out of the blue. Well, never mind. Look, you leave all this to Jeeves and me, all right? Jeeves will get writing and I'll do everything else.
Wonderful.
Hip, hip. Yes, nice girl, that. Corky's found himself, what?
Very charming, sir.
Oh, now, Jeeves, this fellow who phoned up from Chucky, what was his name?
Mr. Bassington-Bassington, sir.
Yes, you heard of him, Jeeves?
I am familiar with the name Bassington-Bassington, sir. There are the Shropshire Bassington-Bassingtons, the Hampshire Bassington-Bassingtons, and, of course, the Kent Bassington-Bassingtons.
Ah, so the world's pretty well stocked up on Bassington-Bassingtons, then?
Tolerably so, sir. Yes.
No chance of a sudden shortage, I mean, huh?
Presumably not, sir. Apparently he is a protégé of Mrs. Gregson's, sir.
What? Aunt Agatha?
He arrived this morning, sir.
Oh, my lord, what is Aunt Agatha going to say? Ah, what is Cyril? I got your message.
You Bertie Wooster?
Absolutely.
Mrs. Gregson said you'd look after me in New York.
Oh, did she? This is my man, Jeeves.
What, oh, Jeeves? Rotten country.
Oh, I don't know. Who knows? Don't you know?
Why didn't the police in New York dress properly? Why don't they wear helmets like they do in London? They look like postmen. It makes it dash confusing. I was just rambling along looking at things, and this fellow who looked like a postman prodded me in the ribs with a stick and started burbling something about jaywalking. I mean, I don't see why a fellow should come 3,000 miles to be prodded and burbled at.
So what did you do?
Well, I prodded him back. And then he biffed me in the eye and lugged me off this beastly place. Still, that's all sorted out now. You know, what I'd really like to do while I'm here, Bertie, is see lots and lots of shows.
Ah, keen on the theatre, are you?
Oh, I'll say.
I tell you what, why don't I drop you off at a pal of mine's rehearsals? You won't mind.
I'd really like that.
Should any of you children be lucky enough to visit California, you may catch a glimpse of the acrobatic little Mexican chickadee. You will learn much more about this little rascal when you are grown up and read Mr. Alexander Wartle's wonderful book, American Birds.
This is the title song from George's new show. You know, Freddie Flowerdew has come to star in it.
No, sir, that intelligence had passed me by.
Well, he is. It's his first American musical. Anyway, this is the opening number. Apparently, he's got all these daughters, you see. Well, in the show, that is.
I understand, sir.
Right, well, the trouble is that the song is written for Freddie Flowerdew and a chorus of girls. It's all marked here, you see. Wherever it says two big Fs, that's for Freddie Flowerdew. Not quite sure what the little Fs are for.
Possibly they are meant to indicate fortissimo, sir.
Possibly, Jeeves, possibly. Well, anyway, to do the thing justice, I think I've got to find a way to approximate the sound of a chorus, so if you wouldn't mind joining in on all the bits that are not marked with a big FF, I'll do those bits and then we can do the chorus together.
I see, sir. I shan't be required to sing falsetto, shall I, sir?
Falsetto, Jeeves?
If I am to sound like a chorus of young ladies, sir.
Well, I don't know. Might just do the trick at that. Well, let's try it. We'll do the first verse again.
Very good, sir.
Ask Dad, that's all they ever say. Ask Dad, they take your breath away. Never seems to flurry them. Oh, pops the perfect backup. Doesn't seem to worry. party then that daddy's due a crack-up.
Well, I don't think so, Jeeves, do you?
It does put a considerable strain on the laryngeal region.
Excuse me, ladies, the house is on fire.
What?
It's all right. It's my line from the show.
Show?
Your friend George gave me a part in his musical.
Oh, Cyril, that's terrific.
Isn't it just... We carry on rehearsing for a couple of weeks, and then we go on the road for a bit until we find a Broadway theatre that will take us.
Well, you certainly seem to have landed on your feet.
Well, it's only a small part, but it's pivotal.
Of course, what I really want to do is films. Everybody says I've got the profile for it.
What a wonderful miracle.
The house is on fire.
I wonder if that line's quite right, George. I mean, wouldn't he say something more like, if you pardon me mentioning it, ladies, the house is on fire?
Oh, that's fine, Cyril, yes, if you'd be more comfortable with it.
As Mr. Alexander Warhol says in his famous book, More American Birds, if you see a sandaling spinning round in the water like a top, it's a phalarope. You see, children, phalaropes do look very like sandalings, of course, but they're famous for spinning round and round in the water. This is a picture of the northern phalarope. Isn't he a handsome little fellow?
I say, it's rather grand, isn't it? What do you think of that, Jeeves?
A very handsome volume, sir.
Well, your masterpiece.
Better still, we sent a copy off to our Uncle Alexander, and Muriel's had a reply already. Read them the letter, Muriel.
Dear Miss Singer, thank you for your charming letter and what a good and useful book A Children's Book of American Birds is. Of course, I should be delighted to meet you at any time. I would tentatively suggest the 25th. Yours sincerely, Alexander Warple.
How about that? Works like a charm, eh, Jeeves?
Extremely gratifying, Sam.
Here we are at the Warple Towers, ma'am.
Georgie Caffin has asked me to tag along with the tour of Ask Dad as a sort of unbiased observer, so I thought I might charge off with them and see a bit of this great country of theirs.
Yeah, it would seem an excellent idea, sir.
I'll also be able to keep an eye on young Bassington-Bassington.
I'm sure Mrs. Gregson will be most grateful, sir.
Yes. Probably show it in the usual manner, viz a kick in the teeth for Bertram. Still, there you are, Jeeves. Just thought I'd mention it. The train leaves from Grand Central tomorrow morning.
Very good, sir. Good night, sir.
Good night, Jeeves.
But the house is on fire.
Well, we're off on our travels, Jeeves. Blasted tricky business, what they call hunting in these parts. They do it without horses. Managed to wing a forest ranger the other day, however. The shows are sold out everywhere. My log cabin marked with an X.
Pardon me for mentioning it, ladies. But the house is on fire.
Westward, ever westward, Jeeves. We're all having a whale of a time, especially Cyril Bassington-Bassington. My sleeping car marked with an X. Show doing famously, Jeeves. I must say the horses out here are rather excitable. The local lads are pretty excitable, too. I've had to buy a few new clothes, I'm afraid, but I'm sure you'll approve. My bunkhouse marked with an X.
Pardon me for mentioning it, ladies, but the house is on fire.
This card shows a picture of the Rockies, Jeeves. They're mountains, as you can see. And dashed rocky they are, too. My rock marked with an X. This is the life, Jeeves. Not a fish in sight, and boots slowly filling with ice water. I did catch a couple of trout the other day. One of them looked exactly like Uffie Prosser. You don't suppose the Uffies hail from Montana, do you? My TP marked with an X. I've now seen Ask Dad 6 billion and blasted 2 times, Jeeves. Or is it 6 billion and blasted 3, and still no blasted sign of a blasted Broadway theatre? My seat in the blasted orchestra stalls marked with a blasted X.
If you'll pardon me mentioning it, ladies, the house is on fire.
P.S. I really think I might leave the show and totter home soon.
Ask Dad.
Well, how have things been in the big city, Mr. Coney Bear?
Oh, we managed to get along pretty good. You ain't by any chance been out west, have you, Mr. Wooster?
Well, yes, as a matter of fact, I have. Yes, we're men of men, you know.
Yeah, I've heard tell. You shooting the Indians?
No, no. Ah, Jeeves, what ho?
Good afternoon, sir.
You know, it really is extraordinary, Jeeves. Almost like coming home. So, much been happening while I've been away?
No, sir, it has been very quiet.
Well, what do you think?
I only hope the poor creature died a peaceful death, sir.
What? Oh, the coat. Yes, it's rather snazzy, isn't it? No, I was referring to the moustache, the old soup strainer.
Very striking, sir.
Yes, rather Ronald Coleman, I thought.
It was Lord Kitchener who sprang to mind on first sighting, sir.
Blast it, Jeeves. I shall do what I like with my own upper lip.
Indeed, sir. Will you be dining in this evening, sir?
No, no, I shall go out to dine, Jeeves, and astound the natives with my mustachios. Well, 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 what?
Mr. Wooster, how are you?
Well, how are you, Miss Singer? Corky around?
I beg your pardon?
Oh, you're waiting for Corky, aren't you?
Oh, I didn't understand. No, I'm not waiting for him.
Oh, you haven't had a row with him, have you?
I don't understand.
Well, what I mean is, I thought you usually dined with him before you went to the theater.
Oh, no. I've left the stage.
Oh, of course, you must be married now.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Oh, that is dash good. Well, I wish you all sorts of happiness and all that.
Thank you very much. I'd like to...
And, of course, the old devil himself. Yes, really put one over on the uncle, eh?
I don't think...
Thanks to Jeeves' masterpiece. What a wheeze.
Alexander, this is a friend of mine, Mr. Wooster. Mr. Wooster, I'd like you to meet my husband, Mr. Warple.
Husband? What rot? No, no, no.
Alexander and I are married.
What uncle? Whose uncle?
Uncle?
You said something about putting one over on the uncle.
No, 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 no. No, I was just telling Miss Singer, Mrs. Warple, about an accident I had. I fell over on my carbuncle.
Carbuncle?
Yes, yes. Really quite painful.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. We've met before, haven't we?
No.
Yeah, you're that weird English sacking fellow. Something's happened to your face, though.
No, no, just the after effects. Must have been my brother. Anyway, tickety-tonk.
$9.40! Come and I'll open the door now! I know you're in there yet, Chisler! You owe me $9.40! You ain't got a chance, Jack. $9.40 for groceries that Mamza owes me.
Corky? Corky?
Who's that?
It's Bertie.
So you've deigned to come back, have you? Well, you're the cause of all this. Now, that'll be all for this morning, nurse.
Same time tomorrow, Mr. Corcoran.
Yes, please.
Painting babies now, eh, Corky?
That's not just any baby, that's the baby.
The baby? What do you mean, the baby?
Muriel's baby, of course. All thanks to your wonderful plan. And if you want an instance of the irony of fate, get acquainted with this. Here's the first commission I ever had to paint a portrait, and the sitter is that human poached egg that has butted into my life and got my allowance cut in half.
But why?
Because the old skinflint says he can't afford to support me and a new family.
But why are you painting it?
$50, Bertie. It's Uncle Alexander's idea. It's supposed to be a surprise for Muriel's birthday. The nurse takes the kid out for a breather, and they beat it down here. I can't refuse, or his uncle would stop my allowance completely.
My poor old Corky. It's like some awful Greek tragedy. Did you know there was a baby, Jeeves?
Of Mr. and Mrs. Warple's? Yes, I saw it announced a few weeks ago in the public prints. I did not think you were emotionally prepared for the news following so hard on your discovery of their marriage, sir.
Where will it all end, Jeeves?
Who can say, sir?
This is a new razor, isn't it?
Yes, sir. I took the liberty of buying it yesterday.
What on earth for? The other one was perfectly all right.
I did not think that it was performing its task with the required efficacy, sir.
Jeeves, I am not going to discuss my facial arrangements.
Very good, sir. I read a most stimulating article in the New York Times, the author of which asserts that moustaches are a most notorious cause for divorces in many parts of the
Jeeves,
country.
Jeeves, I don't care if it's a cause of the staggers in racehorses. I will not have you editing my upper lip.
As you wish, sir. Mr. Bassington-Bassington has returned to New York, sir, last night while you were in bed.
Cyril, has the tour ended?
It seems so, sir.
Good Lord. I wonder if they found a Broadway theatre.
Ofsted, Ofsted.
That's all they ever say.
Ofsted, Ofsted.
They take your breath away. Never seems to flurry them.
This is a great little show we got here, George.
Glad you like it. But my boy doesn't like that sparkly stuff on the beach set in Act Two. Get rid of that, will you? He says it's vulgar.
Right.
And he says you need another reprise of that song, We're All in the Happiness Soup, at the end of the ballroom scene.
Good idea.
My boy's ideas are all good.
Here's the complimentary list for tonight, sir.
I hate giving away tickets. Yes, fine. But add Arthur Prysock to the list, will you?
Prysock, sir?
Art critic on the Chronicle. Him and some crazy Englishwoman are trying to get me to put money into an art gallery. As if I didn't have problems enough.
Very good, sir.
Goodbye, sir.
Who's his boy? What's he talking about?
He's got a 10-year-old son he relies on to tell him what a Broadway audience is going to like and not going to like. He says the mental age is about the same.
Ofsted.
Ofsted. That's all the difference. Ofsted.
Good morning, sir. I trust you had a pleasant walk in the park, sir?
Park? No, Jeeves, I...
In the park, sir. Mrs. Gregson is here to see you, sir.
Aunt Agatha? What? Here in New York?
Bertie? Is that you?
Aunt Agatha! Well, good Lord.
Have you been eating soup, Bertie?
Soup?
Seems to have left a stain on your upper lip.
Oh, no, that's a, you know...
Oh, this is Mr. Prysock. Mr. Prysock, this is the nephew I told you about, Bertie Wooster.
Delighted, delighted.
Mr. Prysock is art critic for the New York Chronicle, Bertie.
For my sins.
I had some business to transact in New York with him, so I thought I would look in on Cyril to see how he is getting on.
Oh, well, he's...
I promised his dear mother, poor Lady Bassington-Bassington, that I would make sure he was perfectly all right.
Yes, well, he's...
Don't interrupt, Bertie. Where is Cyril?
Well, he's out at... that's to say, he's out, Aunt Agatha.
At the library, Mrs. Gregson.
Oh, the library. Well, that sounds like an improvement. As long as you have kept him well away from theatrical circles.
Theatrical circles?
As I instructed you in my letter.
Letter?
Will you kindly stop parroting my every word, Bertie?
Parroting?
The letter of introduction which I gave to Cyril to give to you. He did give it to you, I presume.
Oh, that letter. Yes, yes, of course, yes. That's a wonderful letter.
I don't know what was so very wonderful about it. I merely warned you of Cyril's proclivities. Come, Mr. Prysock. I'm staying at the Waldorf Hotel, Bertie. If you would kindly ask Cyril to contact me there this evening.
Don't forget we're going to see Blumenfield's new show tonight, Mrs. Gregson.
Oh, no, indeed, Mr. Prysock. Cyril should contact me this afternoon.
Oh, Jeeves. You didn't give me any letter from Aunt Agatha.
Oh, didn't I? Well, it only would have depressed you.
Cyril, you have got to leave the show.
Leave the show? On the opening night, on the very threshold of my career, are you mad?
What about the very threshold of my life? Aunt Agatha is coming to the opening.
Well, then she'll see how talented I am and change her tune. Bertie, I really haven't got time for all this. I've got a dress rehearsal in 10 minutes. I've got to relax before I go on. I've got to get into character, explore the core of the part.
You've really got one line.
It's a crucial one, Bertie. I hope I'm not going to be one of those actors who counts their line.
Are you going to leave the show or not?
Never.
Think, Jeeves, think.
I am thinking, sir.
Are you thinking, Jeeves?
Yes, sir.
I can never tell you, sir.
I received a telephone call from Mr. Corcoran this morning, sir.
You're not meant to be thinking about Mr. Corcoran, Jeeves. You're meant to be thinking about the Bassington-Bassington pill.
With respect, sir, I am capable of retaining more than one thought in my mind at the same time. It seems that Mr. Corcoran has finished the painting of the infant and that Mr. Warple is coming round to view it this afternoon.
Well, that's good, isn't it?
Possibly, sir. Mr. Corcoran is keen that we should be present for Mr. Warple's visit.
Bertie, come in.
Come in. Now stop, right there.
Tell me honestly, how does it strike you?
Yes, well, of course, I only saw the kid for a moment.
I've painted the soul of the subject, Bertie. It's a talent we artists have.
Surely a child of that age wouldn't have had time to get a soul like that, would it, Jeeves?
I should think it most unlikely, sir.
Well, here goes.
Well, 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 the big day dawns, eh, my boy? Is it really ready? Is it?
Is this a practical joke?
I think you want to stand a bit further back from it.
I do, I do. I want to stand so far back I can't see the thing through a telescope.
Try sort of half closing your eyes. Yes.
This is what you wasted your time and my money for all these years? A painter? I wouldn't let you paint a house. I gave you the commission thinking you might be competent. And this extract from a drunkard's nightmare is the result. This is the end. Not another cent. Not another cent. Not another cent.
Well, I've said it before, Corky, and I'll say it again. Some people simply do not understand art.
A better death in the jute business, Bertie.
No, Corky, no. Look at it another way.
What other way?
Well? Yes. Still, probably decent of old Jeeves to give you $10 for it.
What do you mean, decent?
Well, discerning, Corky, perspicacious. Old Jeeves knows a thing or two.
Your old Jeeves got me into this mess in the first place.
True, true.
Another donut, Master Sidney?
Sure, I'll have two.
Please have as many as you like.
Disaster, Jeeves. Sorry to interrupt.
Not at all, sir. We were just having tea. Would you care for some?
No, that's fine, Jeeves. You carry on.
What's your name?
Name? Wooster, don't you know, and whatnot.
My pop's richer than you.
Right.
I trust I'm not taking a liberty in entertaining them, sir.
Not at all, Jeeves. If that's your idea of a large afternoon, go ahead. Who is your little friend?
I happened to bump into the young gentleman walking in the park with his father's valet, whom I used to know quite well in London.
My God, I'm exhausted. Dress rehearsal was an absolute disaster. Tea, Jeeves, if you'd be so kind.
Very good, Mr. Bassington.
Have you been to see Aunt Agatha yet?
My dear Bertie, I haven't got a moment. We open in 2 hours. I don't know how much more of this I can take. One gives so much.
Your tea, sir.
Thank you, thank you.
Fish face.
Sorry?
You got a face like a fish.
Well, I'm dashed.
A haddock. I wouldn't have a face like that if you gave me $1 million.
Come here. Extraordinary child. Who was he?
Never met him before today.
Mrs. Gregson and Mr. Prysock are ascending in the elevator, sir.
What? I've got to get out of here.
If I can suggest the fire escape, sir?
Jeeves, you're up to something. I know that look.
Sir?
Ah, what ho, Aunt Agatha. What ho, Mr. Prysock.
Is it possible for you to find a more civilized form of greeting, Bertie?
Should I make some more tea, sir?
Oh, yes, Jeeves, make some more tea.
Very good, Mrs. Gregson.
Cyril did not come to see me.
Oh, really? No, well, I expect he got tied up at the library.
Well, he's here now, I trust.
Well, actually, no.
No? Oh, this is really most unsatisfactory.
I think he went... Jeeves, where is Mr. Bassington today, do we know?
At the museum, sir.
At the museum, that's right. And then he was... Jeeves, what are you doing?
I'm hanging this picture, sir.
Oh, we're not going to have that beastly thing in here, are we?
It is a Corcoran, sir.
My nephew knows nothing about art, Mr. Prysock.
Well, I know a bally awful painting when I see one.
Oh, let me see.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Yes, yes, yes. And it is a genuine...
Corcoran? Yes, madam?
Of course. The tone, the line is unmistakable.
Typical of his early work. Still Life with Eggplant is the title of the piece.
So clever, so clever. At first glance, there's almost the hint of a human face.
We must have this work for the gallery, we must. What did you pay for it, Bertie?
I didn't. I wouldn't give you tuppence for the beastly thing.
Poor Bertie.
Then who bought it?
I did, sir. I gave 10 for it.
10? I'll give you 15 for it right here and now.
Oh, really, sir? I would be loath to part with it.
17, and that's my final offer.
For less than 18?
We must have it, Mr. Prysock. This is just the sort of work that will persuade Mr. Blumenfield of our serious intent.
18,000, then, and exclusive access to any other Corcoran you can lay your hands on.
That's fine, good. Yeah, that's fine, good. No, don't wear that tie. Can't we get him a less ostentatious tie? Fine, fine. Those frills are looking a bit tired, Nesta. It's fine.
What's that awful child doing here?
Well, that's Blumenfield's son.
Good Lord, Cyril, that's the one you biffed.
Hey, you, turn around.
He did what?
Biffed, as in biffed.
Pop, that's the one. That one's no good.
Which one, darling?
The one with a face like a fish.
Oh, that one?
Yep, he's rotten.
I thought so, too.
What the devil do you mean?
Don't yell at me.
I've a dash good mind to bat little brute round the ear again.
What? Now, see here, mister, I don't know your name, but...
My name is Cyril Bassington-Bassington. And let me tell you, the Bassington-Bassingtons are not...
I don't give a $3 cuss what the Bassington-Bassingtons are accustomed to.
You gotta work good to work for my pop.
You, I'll come over there and stuff that hat down your neck in a minute.
Do you know who you're talking to? This boy's my son.
Well, you both have my deepest sympathy.
That does it. Okay, Caffin, here's the deal. If that man's in it, the show's off.
You can't do that.
Watch me.
Come on now, darling.
I didn't want to do the dressy part, Damon. I didn't want to do it now.
Don't forget this, Bertie. Now, at the end of the number, you just step out onto the stage and you say, you'll pardon me for mentioning it, ladies, but the house is on
fire. Yes, I know. I've seen that blasted thing about 1,000 times. My aunt is sitting out there just waiting to pounce. She thinks that acting is the next thing to devil worship.
I won't forget this, Bertie.
Nor me.
Fire!
What are you doing here? Mm. Oh, I don't know yet. The Bertie has led you astray. Now get back there.
For God's sake, George!
I like your belly nerve. I was trying to help.
Bertie! Bertie! Oh, Bertie! Bertie! Oh, what on earth do you think you are doing? Fully responsible, Bertie. I warned you that this might happen. Don't answer back. You will return with me to London, and you will personally apologize to poor Lady Bassington-Bassington. Oh, silence!
Last time we shall get the New York Sunday papers, sir.
Ah, thank you, Jeeves.
Mr. Caffin's new show has been retitled Where's the Fire and has excellent advance reservations.
Good Lord.
The fiasco which attended the opening of the entertainment afforded publicity such as could not be bought, sir.
I suppose you're right, Jeeves.
There is also an excellent review of Mr. Corcoran's exhibitions, and...
You know, Jeeves, if I'd been in your place, I think I'd have kept old Price Ox check.
Mr. Corcoran was generous enough to pay me a percentage, sir, for acting as his agent in the matter.
You really are a marvel, Jeeves, you know. That and nobbling young Sidney Blumenfield.
I endeavour to give satisfaction, sir.
You know, Jeeves, in spite of the fact that we're being dragged back to dear old Blighty under somewhat ignominious circumstances by an enraged aunt, I shan't be sorry to go.
No, indeed, sir. It will be a pleasure to be home.
Now, Jeeves, about this moustache.
Yes, sir?
You don't like it, do you?
It is not my place to offer an opinion on the object, sir.
Well, to tell you the truth, I'm not all that keen on it either. I only kept the bally thing on to show who's master.
Oh, I trust there was never any doubt about that, sir.
Quite. Yes, well, go get the razor, will you, Jeeves?
Thank you, sir.
Oh, yes, Corcoran's a major artist.
Too lovely.
Me too.
They say there's one hanging in the White House.
That's very moving.
Congratulations.
Well done.
Superb. Absolutely superb.
Corky, it's a triumph. A triumph, yes. That's right, that's right.